Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold Jerry, retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanakwadi's second coming of Jesus. And this golden temple is the same size as the holiest of holy that used to be in Jerusalem. So you can't have two temples of God. So that is why they can't rebuild temple. And a fire came from the foundation, made them to run away. So only the western wall is left, and western wall is for the sons of Satan, or sons of the Most High Satan. And that is what they are, and they are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning. That will take place when Israel is 70 years old. Nobody can touch Israel till. So here I'm doing my book, chapter 6, the belief and faith. Further, the nomadics renew their inner man, the Christ. This is the temple of God, and the priest of the temple of God is called royal priest, and the priest of Moses sitting in the temples made by human hand, they are called priest, and this is a supernatural father inside. This is the temple of God, of the supernatural father, so we are royal priest. Further, the nomadics renew their inner man, the master of his own destiny, the Christ, and not the inner woman, a blind follower. Every day, the inner self of a person, whether in flesh, the person is a male or a female, is a man when the person is led by his own logical reasoning capabilities, are called intuition. With a crystal clear conscience of a little child, of little childlike, and it is the person is a woman when the person lets his own conscience to be overruled by the others, such as the Pope, clerics of Mammon, etc. And Saul was being controlled by his Rabbi Gamaliel. So then Saul was a woman. But when Jesus set him free, he became the master of his own destiny, a man. So, and it is a woman when the person lets his own conscience to be overruled by the others, such as the Pope, clerics of Mammon, etc., and the Antichrist, who impose their own views upon their blind followers. This is also called the prostitution of soul, and it is against the very free spirit of gospel, in which every one of us gives his own account to God. Thus, gnostically speaking, belief is the road to salvation. It is a narrow road, which Christ Jesus paved with the stepping stones of gospel. And faith in God is our journey, which is measured by the depth of soil into which the seed of gospel takes its roots. So just comparing, the different hope in Holy Spirit. That is our, you know, gift we expect from our Father. Our hope in Holy Spirit, our reward, is the moisture that nourishes our religious plant. Love of our royal father, Agape, is the cool and refreshing air that tenderly blows through our hearts. And the knowledge of gospel is the light of the royal kingdom of God that enables us to perceive the narrow road that leads to our Father's vineyard, where the true wine, Christ Jesus, exists, is where the true wine, Christ Jesus, has been planted by our Father, to which we must graft ourselves to bring forth the fruit of our labor, the preaching of gospel that pleases our Father, who puts in his sickle to harvest the ripe crop. So when we preach gospel, then our Father is glorified and he is happy. So when he is happy, then he will put his sickle. He puts the sickle to take the fruit into his barn as the sons of the Most High, which we call saint. So people become saint, you know, when our Father had put the sickle around you. So this is a short video, and hope you enjoy it. And our Father God blesses you.